what we're going to do today is just go back, go through a lot of the activities we did last year. We've paid out, take you through some of them, and some of them too are really quick, simple ideas that you can go and implement tomorrow.
Our model started back in 2009 when we all became national partnership schools. We had very similar needs, we had similar cohorts, and we were also all able to gain some funding that we pooled and decided that we'd collaborate upon so that we could provide best options for our schools and our communities. So we've been operating in a neighbourhood model for the past 5 years. Our model is based upon a distributive but connected leadership model. So there's four levels of leadership. There's the principals that have the global perspective of the neighbourhood and our vision. Then we have our assistant principals who are really the nuts and bolts of the organisational team. Beneath them we have our numeracy and literacy leaders. Beneath that layer then we have our classroom teachers and many of our education support, and they also are able to access our professional learning models.
So this afternoon we'll actually get an opportunity to really look at, you know, what we've brought and share our resources and decide what kind of activities would benefit our teachers.
We really knew that we could be more effective if we pulled the expertise of the talent that we already had in our school, so we wanted to start with that as the base and then to build that leadership capacity. So we all identified in our schools the potential leaders and grew them, and our assistant principals took on a really strong curriculum leadership role in that. And their role really is to build the capacity of the classroom teacher practice. So they're right at the instructional level.
Our staff have really valued the model that we use because they feel like it is ongoing professional learning. Yeah. It's not like what has happened in the past where schools take something on board, tick the box and move on to the next.
And the last couple of things I put for this task, I'm going to give this to my kids tomorrow, is I was just going to say to them, you have to identify the aspects of those shapes and also give it a name, and I might try and get them up to the class and present what that famous landmark is or how it's used or why they've used it.
So. The issue that we were trying to address was the student outcome issue that we faced in all three schools. I think giving an opportunity to have funding that we could pull together to actually get a critical friend in to have a look at what we were doing internally as schools was really important. And basically I think at the end of the day what we were after was an improved achievement across all learning areas. Obviously we started with literacy, but then it's moved into the Peter Sullivan work with numeracy as well.
The model's been great in that Peter's really challenged our thinking in the area of numeracy, and we're still being challenged. Yep. Teams of teachers across our three schools are released. They attend professional learning with Peter. They also engage in professional conversations with each other, with Peter on those 2 days. They observe a lesson, and there's that feedback, you know, what we observed and, you know, what we saw happening.
Exactly.
Then following up from those 2 days, within our schools, we build in time into our professional learning timetables to share that knowledge across with the rest of our teaching staff. And then normally about 2 weeks after Peter's been here, those numeracy leaders spend a half day again together to plan our neighbourhood professional learning workshop, which our numeracy leaders then deliver workshops for all the teaching staff across the neighbourhood.
As the three schools, the whole staff are involved in whole day curriculum days with Peter Sullivan. And then as part of the numeracy team, a smaller group of us gets together and we do follow-up work with Peter and after Peter is gone to contribute more professional learning to the three schools.
And whilst we work as a group, as a neighbourhood, the other benefit is that we can then take it back to our own schools and deliver it in the way that suits the school, specific school. We all have different students, so we try and make sure that the program we're delivering is directed particularly to our students and what their needs are.
We've taken away activities from Peter, the practical activities, and then we've trialled them in our classrooms, and then we've got them back as a section or as a neighbourhood and talked about how did that go and what were the benefits and where could we go from there and what we can improve, and then from that create even more activities around the same idea that Peter's given us. and then again implement them into our schools and into our classrooms.
And it's mainly about the way in which we should be differentiating within our lessons. So you're catering for those children that are working below expected level, but then we really need to remember those students that are working above their level. So where do we go next? What's the next thing that we need to be teaching these students that have already mastered their expected level?
Quite often we find a lot of teachers for some reason have a fear of teaching numeracy and teaching maths because they themselves didn't like it or weren't good at it.
Exactly.
And I think that we're all, the way that Peter as well challenges us, we're all learning and working together, and it's building our own knowledge in the fact that, yeah, I can do that.
Exactly.
And I guess one of the great things with Peter and then the neighbourhood workshops, we provide lots of opportunities for the teachers to actually do the activities so that they then have an understanding before then delivering and sharing them with their students. And like for tonight, our numeracy leaders will have trialled them in their classrooms with their students, so then they can draw on their experiences, what went well, what they'd do differently next time.
I think professionally it's good for us as assistant principals. You don't forget the nuances of classroom practice. You don't forget what's really important. It's the teaching and learning, isn't it?